We have seen the two types of biasing for MOSFET. One is the negotiated biasing, and the other one is the imposed biasing.
Imposed biasing.
We are not going to go into the details of imposed biasing because that is out of the scope. But as far as negotiated biasing is concerned, we are going to see an analysis and subsequently the design of the biasing network. So, if you remember, we have already carried out a similar kind of exercise for bipolar junction transistor.
Yes,
we are talking about the biasing networks. So first of all, we said that okay, there are two possible problems, so as to say. One is, given the components, you are supposed to find out the Q point, and vice versa, if you are given a Q point, you are supposed to design the network. So in a similar manner, we will take today's examples. So the problem here is of analysis type. So determine IDQ and VDSQ in the given circuit. So this is your R1, this is R2, we have VDD as plus 12 volts, RD is given as 4 kilo ohms, RS is given as 2 kilo ohms, R1 is given as 80 kilo ohms, and R2 is given as 40 kilo ohms. Okay, you are supposed to find out the ID, that is the Q point, VDSQ and IDQ. This is what you are supposed to find. Also given are the parameters of the MOSFET, that is K dash K dash W by L, which is given as 2 milliamperes per volt square. Be careful with the units and with this milliampere as well. Threshold voltage VT is given as 1 volt. Okay, so what is our objective? Objective is to find the Q point. Q point means what? First of all, I'll have to find out IDQ. And then I'll have to find out VDSQ. In order to find out IDQ, I'm supposed to find out VGSQ. Because VGSQ will set up IDQ. Okay? So first task will be to do that. So here is a solution for that. We find first step one, let us say, let us not go into the number of steps, just look at the method in which we are solving this problem. We find VG. Now what is this VG? VG is the voltage at this point. This is VG. Okay. And then we have this here, we have VGS. Okay, so we find VG. How do we find VG? VG will be given as what? VDD into R2 divided by
R1 plus R2.
that it means 12 volts multiplied by 40k divided by 40k plus 80k. So can anyone find out this for me? It is 12 volt into, so this will be 40 by 120 k. Both the cases will be cancelled out. So this will be only 4 volts.
4 volts, sir.
Okay. We also have Vs. Now what is this Vs? Vs is the voltage across Rs.
Rs across, yes, sir.
Yes, so this voltage is Vs. So Vs, we have, what is the value of Vs? Equation, simply Ohm's law, ID into Rs.
Rs.
Okay. Okay, now we'll make a note here that ID, if I take in milliamperes, most of the times your ID will be in milliamperes. So Vs happens to be, now what is Rs? Rs is given as
2 kilo ohms.
2 kilo ohms. So this ID, which is in milliamperes, multiplied by 2 kilo ohms, that milli and kilo will cancel, and yes, what I get here is 2 into ID. Yes, agreed?
Sir. Yes, sir.
So therefore, what is the value of VGS that we have seen? Applying the loop equation at the input side. This loop, if you see, so apply KVL here, what do we get? VGS minus
VGS
minus ID
into Rs
is equal to
zero.
So what I can have is VGS is equal to VG minus ID into Rs. This translates to, what is VG? We have calculated here.
4 volts.
4. 2. 4 volts.
4 volts.
And what is ID into Rs that we have calculated?
2 ID.
That is Vs. That is 2 ID. Okay. So this is one equation that we have. What is our objective? Objective is to find, don't lose the sight of the big picture. What do you want to find?
IDQ.
We have to find.
Yeah, but before VQ. That.
For that, we need to find
VGSQ.
Yes,
we are supposed to find VGSQ. So this is one equation involving VGSQ. But we also know for MOSFET in saturation, there is one equation for drain current. What is that? ID
is equals to 1 by 2 K dash W by
yes.
L.
VGS w. minus VT bracket square.
Yes, sir.
So this is the equation that we have. So if I use a similar kind of, I substitute all the values here, half K dash W by L was given as how much?
Sir, 2 milliamperes per volt square.
Correct. So I will multiply here by 2, this thing, value for this. And since I am establishing ID in milliamperes, that milliampere over here is taken care of.
Yes, sir.
Remember that this is in milliamperes. ID is in milliamperes. That is for computational ease. Okay. And then what is the value of VGS? We don't know. That is what we are supposed to find out. What is VT?
1 volts.
1 volt. So this gives me another equation. So it simply translates to ID is equal to this 2 will go away. VGS minus 1 bracket square. All right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, what do we have here is substituting for VGS and rearranging, what do we get? Yes. Rather, we substitute.
So the above value of VGS, which we have got, that we have to substitute in the second equation. So you are not audible. So you are not audible.
Okay. So instead of what is the value of ID here? VGS minus 4. Okay, divided by 2. Either you can substitute this. My intention is to solve this. My intention is to get an equation. It will be a quadratic equation. So substituting for the value of ID and then subsequently solving, I will get something like 2VGS square minus 3VGS minus 2 equal to 0. Try it out whether you are getting the same thing. Please do this. I am substituting for this ID, I am substituting the value that I got. So what was the value that I got? VGS minus 4 by 2 is equal to VGS minus 1 bracket square. I'm substituting for ID in this equation. What do I get? VGS minus 4 is 2 into VGS square minus 2 VGS
yes.
plus 1. If I expand this, 2VGS square minus 4VGS plus 2.
Plus 2.
Okay? So now I can convert this into 2VGS square. This VGS transpose will be minus
3VGS.
This 4 goes over here.
Minus 2.
No, something is wrong.
But it should be 4 minus VGS, not VGS minus 4.
Yeah.
4 minus VGS. VGS 2, minus 1 by 2.
Okay. So, yeah, just a mix up of the sign, right? Right.
Okay. Yes, so
ID is equal to what?
4 minus. Yes.
4 minus VGS by 2. Okay, so this is wrong. Alright, so ultimately you'll get this thing.
Yes, sir.
So this will be minus, this will be plus, something like that. Okay, so what we have is ultimately this equation. 2VGS minus 3VGS, 2VGS square minus 3VGS minus 2. This is a quadratic equation, and you know how to solve the quadratic equation.
Yes, so
x square plus bx plus c equal to 0. So what do we have the solution? X is equal to minus
1 by 2.
No, in terms of this generic equation, minus b
plus minus b plus minus
square minus c by 2a minus b plus or minus
and b square minus 4ac
b square minus
4ac divided by 2a.
So solve this equation, we get two possible answers. Now this has to be done carefully. We get two possible answers. So can you please solve this for me?
So 2 yes. Minus 1 by 2.
Yes, we have BGS, two values of BGS. Because it's a quadratic, we have two roots. What will it be? Come on. Come on, guys. Solve this equation for me.
Just
2 and minus 1 by 2.
Yes, I get 2.0 and minus 0.5. Remember, this is volts. Theek hai?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So, which one is correct? Which one is valid rather? This is again very important. Which one is valid? Now apply your concepts that we have already seen. For the MOSFET, of course the N MOSFET, in order for the MOSFET to be either in saturation region or simply to turn on, what is the requirement of VGS? What is the requirement of VGS? Come on. For the last 2-3 lectures, we have been seeing this. Should be? VGS should be? Yes.
Greater than 0.
Greater than VT.
Don't forget this.
So greater here, than
VT. Which condition is valid?
Sir, the 2 volts one, because VT
is given as 1. This is the correct answer.
Yes, sir.
That which we are looking out for. So we have ultimately found out VGS. In fact, this is nothing but VGS cube, which is 2.0 volt. So we have found out what is VGSQ. Are all the steps clear to all of you?
Yes, sir.
So the acceptable solution is only this and not this. Now, can I find out what is ID? In fact, it will be IDQ.
Sir.
So IDQ. What was the equation for IDQ? 4 minus
VGS divided by
2. So this is 4 minus 2 by 2. This gives me what?
1 milliampere.
Yes, don't forget this milliampere, because we are talking about ID always right now in this, as far as this example is concerned, we are talking in only in terms of milliamperes. So we have found out IDQ. Now is it possible for me to find out VDSQ?
Yes, sir.
It will be VDD minus IDQ into RD plus
RS.
We've seen this equation so many times. So this gives me 12 volts minus 1. milliampere, of course, but RD and RS we are taking in kilo ohm, so that will cancel off. That is the reason why I'm writing a 4 plus 2. How much this turns out to be?
Sir, 6 volts.
6 volts. So I have solved this problem. The Q point happens to be what? 6 volts and?
6 volts, 1 milliampere.
1 milliampere. Easy?
Yes, sir.
But one final step is remaining. One final step is remaining. What is that final step? We must ensure or check for the consistency with the assumed mode of operation.
Yes, sir.
What is that mode of operation? Whether really we have assumed so many things like the device is in saturation. Okay, but we must ensure that, no, you have to check the solution for consistency. And for the device to be in saturation, we have already said VDSQ should be greater than VGSQ minus VT greater than 0.
Yes, sir.
Remember, this is NMOS. So, does this condition validate? Is this condition satisfied? We find VDSQ is 6 volts, which is obviously greater than 2 volts minus 1 volt.
5 volts greater than. So
condition is valid.
Valid.
And so our solution is acceptable.
Yes, sir.
Is it fine? Any doubts, yes, any questions, sir, with this particular numerical example?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Sure?
Yes,
all, yes, of you?
There are 52 students. I'm hearing only 3 or 4 voices. बाद में यही प्रॉब्लम आएगा एग्जाम में.
सर यू आर नॉट ऑडिबल.
ओके
सर यू आर नॉट ऑडिबल.
Okay, I was saying you have to be very much attentive for the during the lectures, because these things you will not get anywhere on the net, nor in, yes, any book, as a matter of fact. Other students, yes, really don't understand these problems. Those who are not attentive, they are going to suffer. Anyways, so obviously the next flavor of the problems, possible problems, is you have to design the biasing network. For MOSFET. Okay. So here goes the example. Biasing the network means what? Biasing the network means what? Or design
of the Q.
Means what? You have to find out R1, R2. RD and RS may or may not be given to you. So that also you may have to determine sometimes. We'll see that during the design of the amplifier itself. All right?
So that you have written designing the biasing network, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, come again. I didn't get you properly. I thought. Come again, please.
Sir, I was saying, like, the question to designing the biasing, that is written network now after biasing.
No, I'm not able to understand your question itself. Designing of biasing network means to design.
No, sir. Sir, I was asking, like, it is written network now, like, after biasing, this term.
Biasing network means what? This is a network itself, no? This yes, itself is a network.
Set the stop form.
Yeah? This one?
No, sir, got it.
Come on. Okay. So determine. R1 and R2 such that IDQ is 0.25 milliamperes. Okay. And a condition is given, R1 parallel R2 should be 60 kilo ohms. Remember why R1 parallel R2 condition is required? We'll see that in a couple of maybe lectures. Because R1 and R2 are the only elements which decide the input impedance of the circuit. So R1 parallel R2 60 means I want a high impedance circuit. High input impedance circuit. Okay. So I'll redraw this. Again, VDD is given to you. This is given as 4K. This is given as 2 kilohertz. Okay. So determine R1 and R2 such that IDQ, or in simple plain words, the Q point is given to us. How will it look like? So this is VDSQ, IDQ. VDSQ you can easily determine from here. What is that VDSQ? VDD
minus
IDQ
plus
RS. Can you find out 12 volt minus 0.25 milliamperes into 4K plus 2K? That is 12 volt minus 0.25 into 6.
So 10.5 volts.
Yes.
10.5 volts.
10.5. So you have Q point to be designed at 10.5 volts. 10.5? Really? Okay, ho sakta hai. And 0.25 milliamp. So this is our requirement.
Yes, sir, it's 10.5 only.
Okay, doesn't matter. So, here goes the solution. Again, this point will be called as VG. I mean, the voltage at this point is VG. Can I find out what is VS? Remember, this is the same current ID. So, our objective is to find VG. That is what is just where the starting point is. In fact, this is what is required, isn't it? Ultimately, who is going to decide this value of IDQ? IDQ is set by what?
VGSQ.
VGS.
Yes, sir.
We know that VGS is equal to VG minus ID into RS.
Into RS.
Isn't it? So first of all, we'll find out VG also. So once we find out VG, I can easily find out VGS. Or rather, if I find out VGS, I can find out VG. And then finally, what is VG?
VDD into
R2 plus R2
upon R2.
So once I have this, I also have another relationship for R1 and R2. What is that? R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2 is going to be
60 kilo.
Correct. So once I have this equation and this equation, I can find out the values of R1 and R2. Two equations, two unknowns. So our objective is to find out VG. Okay. Now if IDQ is 0.25 milliamperes. First of all, I'll find out this. So VS is equal to ID into RS. That gives me 0.25 milliamperes into, what is the value of RS? 2 kilo ohms. So this turns out to be, so VS turns out to be how much?
0.5 volt.
Okay. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Now remember that we had one equation, VGSQ, right? Color all together so that
so you are not audible.
You remember this equation?
Yes, sir.
Where do I get this equation from?
So the so when we write the equation for ID and saturation.
Yes, very good.
1 by 2 K dash W by L in bracket VGS minus VT whole.
So if you arrange it, you can get VGS like this.
Yes.
ठीक है ना?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now can I find out VGSQ here? VT is known to us. Okay. Did I forget to mention that the device has got?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I may have forgotten. Okay, so the K dash W by L will be given as, again, 2 milliamperes per volt. The same device and VT is 1 volt. This is given.
Okay, sir.
So can I find out VGSQ now?
Yes, sir.
How much is this? VT is what? 1 volt plus square root of 2 into divided by K dash W by L is given as 2 milliampere per volt square. Don't forget this milliampere, milliampere will cancel here. So how much do I get? Can anyone calculate this for me?
So 1.5 volts.
Yes, I get 1.5 volts. Now, is it possible for me to find out VG now? Look at this equation. Yes. Look at this equation. We already know this. We know this. So is it possible for us to find out VG? Yes. So VG happens to be, VG happens to be what?
So VGS 1 volt.
VGS minus IDRS.
Yes, sir.
How much is that?
1 volt.
1 volt.
1 volt. Really?
Yes, sir.
Yes, 1 volt.
Yes, sir.
So 1.5 minus 0.5, it will be 1 volt. So VGS minus IDRS.
No. Wait a minute.
Sir, equation will be like VG minus VGS minus IDRS is equals to 0. So we'll get VG as VG. Oh, sir, it will be 2 volt.
Yeah.
2 volt.
That is what I was surprised to hear this from you.
Yes, sir. 2 volts.
Okay. So VG is given as 2 volts here, but what is VG? VDD into
R2 upon
divided
R2.
By R1 plus R. So I have one equation saying R2 by R1 plus R2 is VG is what you have calculated as 2 volts, VDD is 12 volts. This will be 1/6. So one equation I get is R2 divided by R1 plus R2 is 1/6. Call this equation number 1. Another relationship between R1 and R2 we already have as R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2 as 60K. This is call this equation 2. This is given. Now solve this, these two equations. Solve equation 1 and 2 simultaneously. Two equations, two unknowns. What is the simplest way you can do it?
Sir, putting 1 and 2.
Divide 2 by 1. And what do you get?
R1 is equal to 360.
360 kilo. Don't forget this K here. Many students commit the mistake of forgetting these terms. Now, is it possible for me to find out R2?
Yes, sir.
Do it. Substitute the value of R1 in any one of the equations and you find out R2. Do it, come on.
So 72 kilo ohms.
Perfect. Say 70 kilo ohms.
Perfect. So our problem is solved. Isn't it?
So,
we're supposed to find out R1 and R2 so that the Q point was as per the given requirements. Okay, let us jump to another software.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
So what if like this RD and RS was not given and we have to find that also?
That we will see in the design itself. Okay, we are going to design a common source small signal voltage amplifier using MOSFET.
Okay, sir.
We will see it over there.
Okay, sir.
All right.
Yes, sir.
Okay, I'll tell you just a brief about it immediately. Let me first of all get to this software again.
Yes, sir.
Just a moment, hold on please. I'm going to share that screen. You see the screen?
Yes, sir.
So we have again a demo, an interactive demo as that. So VT is given as 1 volt. You can, of course, modify this. Let us see what exactly is the situation. So VDD was 12 volts, so I'll put 12 over here. RS was given as 2K, RD was given as 4K. First of all, the analysis part, 80K and 40K.
Yes, sir.
And then I compute this. See, I get two possible values. You are supposed to select the valid one. So 2 volt is valid. So this is how you get. All right. Do you see this?
No.
No?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So just like the biasing software, which I have already shared with you for BJT, I have written this software for MOSFET. Okay, how many of you have tried that software? Guys? How many of you have tried that software? Students, please answer. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
So how many of you have tried that software? No one. Software is,
yes sir, I think
you have tried it.
No, I've not tried it.
Anmol Dubey, you have not tried it. Nobody has done that. Come on guys, this software is exclusively made for you guys. No other students will have access to this from anywhere. A unique software specifically designed for my students. And if you are not trying that, not using it, what is the point? Huh? Anyways, this was supposed to give you an insight as to how to place at the cue point and what is the significance of the cue point being lying on the center of the load line. This is what was the intention. Unfortunately, nobody gives a thought to that. Nobody is working out that way. So I'm not going to share any more softwares with you. Anyway, for the design, I'm going to keep this same. And here I'm going to have this 0.25 here. And it was 10.5. And if I say design, see what are the values of R1 and R2 it calculates, 360 and 72, exactly as we have done. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
But this is not a very good placement of cue point, as you can see here very well. That you are going to have a clipping of the signal.
Yes,
sir. Or the signal has to be very, 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 very small. In fact, not possible here. So, doesn't matter at this point. But see how we are. So given the cue point, for example, here, this will give you, see how the load line is reflected on the input or the transfer characteristics as well as on the output character. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, let us go to multisim and see whether we are going to have the same results, whatever we have seen in the theoretical calculations. Just wait for some time where I launch multisim.
Okay, sir.
Okay, do you see the multi-sim screen now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so our VDD was 12 volts. We'll start with the analysis first. This was 80. This was 40. And this is 2K, this will be 4K.
Okay.
All right. So I'm interested in finding out VDSQ and ID. But before that, I have to make sure that the device parameters are as per our requirements. So threshold voltage, one transconductance parameter, that is this K dash. Here K dash, see that? Are you able to see the screen?
Yes, yes, sir.
For edit model, are you able to see that edit model window?
Which one is transconductance?
Yes, sir. Yes, are
you able to see that?
KP? Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It happens to be that K dash which you are referring to. So I've set it as 2 milliamperes per volt square threshold voltage. This you have to verify, okay, before going in for this simulation. Okay. Because different transistors will give you different results. Okay, so what do I get? If I run this software in interactive mode, my IDC will be 1 milliampere. Does it agree with our results?
Yes, sir.
What about this?
Sir.
6 VDSQ volts. With 6 volts. All right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. So that is fine. Now, we had calculated some other things for design. So let us see if that design works out. So R1 was 360.
Yes, sir.
K. This was 72K. Other things are pretty much the same. So if I run this software, what should my IDC, what should be this value?
0.25.
Yeah, and this should be?
10.5 volts.
You get it? Are you able to see this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, sir. So our design methodology and analysis methodology is all verified using simulation also.
So a virtual MOSFET, we are using it now over here.
Yeah, you can use virtual MOSFET here because we want to modify the parameters.
Yes, sir. Okay. Sir.
Okay. Other actual devices, probably they won't let you modify this KP and BT may be there, but you may not be able to modify it. So this is fully customizable transistor, MOSFET. All right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I don't think we have much time, but all right. So actually, I wanted to start with the design of the common source amplifier, but it seems that we don't have enough time, only 10 minutes are remaining. I can't complete it without that. So for the time being, have I shown you the transfer and the output characteristics of MOSFET using multisim? Yes, guys. I don't remember showing it. So just let us have a look at.
Yes, sir.
The EMOSFET transfer characteristics. So do you see the screen now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so if I go for the DC sim, I'll be having something like this.
So we have not seen this before.
You have not seen this. Okay, okay. I just had a hint
that
possibly this was missed out. So these are the transfer characteristics for EMOSFET. You see that this voltage VGS now is positive. Okay. And
yes.
Approximately at this 2 volts, which is the threshold, for this particular device, 2 volts is the threshold. Now you can see I can modify this threshold also.
Yes, sir.
If I make it 3. And if I run the sweep again, see what is happening. You see the difference?
Yes, sir.
So earlier the curve was starting from here. That is the drain current was starting to flow after 2 volts. Now it is started flowing after 3 volts. ठीक है ना?
Yes,
I expect all of you to play with these parameters. See? Oh God, multisim has stopped working. Okay, doesn't matter. I will go back to multisim, start it again.
Sir, you have explained it once before also.
Sorry?
Sir, you have shown it once before the previous classes.
All these things?
Yes, sir.
Because there are so many things, right? E-MOS, depletion mode MOSFET, P-type and P-channel, N-channel. So I thought it was remaining. But anyways, let this be a revision. Doesn't matter.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, now is it okay, visible to all?
Yes, sir.
So we are trying to find out now the transfer, the output characteristics. So they look like this. All right?
Yes, sir.
Now you'll see that the output resistance, RO, is what? Can you find out what is the output resistance here? Just by visual inspection. What is R out? RO.
So you are not audible. So you are not audible.
Okay. Do you remember that finite output resistance was because of some parameter?
Yes.
That parameter was called as what? Isn't it? And then we modified the equation to accommodate that effect. So let us see if we can have such a kind of effect here. So I don't know whether lambda can be changed here. Okay, here you see lambda. So if I change it to 50. What is the change? All right. So I'm having here, lambda should not be 50. It may be, yes. 5. Still a problem. Having some problem here, but doesn't matter. See what is the problem that is happening is because this has been extended to 24 volts. So instead of that, I will restrict it to 5 volts. Still, there is a problem here. Anyways, if I substitute this with an actual device. N 7000. Okay, and then if I code for this sweep, you will see that. Okay, now again I have to do this. 20. Okay. So here, at larger values, you'll see that there is a slight slope over here in the saturation region. Okay, it may not be perfectly parallel. What is the lambda? Let us find out what is the lambda for this. No, the MOS 1 model does not have lambda. They must have given RD is given. Okay, doesn't matter. So the point is that for higher values, see what happens. So this may be a slightly, you know, there will be a kind of slope for this curves. Okay. So I want all of you to experiment with these things. Just don't take anything at the face value. What's wrong with this? Okay. Vt was 2 volts. Conductance is yes. Lambda, I am not able to understand this. Why it is not able to change this value of lambda? Okay, now I get it. Maybe 200. No, something is wrong here. Not able to understand this at this point. Anyway, doesn't matter. I want all of you to play with these parameters and see for yourselves.
Okay, sir.
Okay. 1/50, 0.002. I was trying to put there the early voltage. Yes, finally I got it. Okay, you see the curve, the slope now? Do you see the slope?
Yes, sir.
This is the finite output resistance. What I was doing, what error I was committing? Here I was putting directly 1/lambda. The early voltage. Yes. There 50 and 100 and 200 and so on and so forth, whereas it's supposed to be 1/50 or 1/200 or whatever, right?
Yes, so
okay, so we have sorted that out. Okay, doesn't matter. So have you understood now the import the concept of lambda also?
Yes, so
and why it is going to have a profound effect on the output resistance of the device. Okay. So I think we have run out of time now. So any doubts, any questions in today's session?
No, sir.
Okay, so we'll stop here for today. Thank you.
Thank you.